You were right. I know I can't get enough of you. Leave it all to bloom. You were right.
My name's Daniel Klien, and my company's Pursuit of Giants Game Fishing. So I sort of travel up and down the east coast from Cairns down to Bermagui game fishing. The Cookie's from Staten Island, which is over in America in New York. Cookie's based in Yowie Bay, so lives at the owner's house down here at Yowie Bay, and spends about 3 months of the year up in Cairns and about 3 months of the year up at Port Stephens. Just chasing the seasons. Yeah, billfish shootout was pretty slow. I think the first day we caught a pretty wild blue marlin that did all the right things and tried to come for a boat ride, but luckily it didn't jump in, which was quite lucky. And we had another bite. But yeah, all in all, it was quite slow, to be honest. Yeah, a lot of current. But we did pretty good. A lot of boats didn't catch any, so catching a fish was definitely a bonus. So the reels we used are all Tagra reels. Tiagra 130s and Tiagra 80s. Like, I like to run heavy tackle just because you never know when the biggest one ever is going to jump on. So that's sort of what we're fishing for. And when we're blue marlin fishing, we're fishing for a big one. The Viking 56 has three bedrooms, a double bed in one, which is the master cabin. Yeah, it's got a double and a single in another cabin. Then it's got a double and a single in the third cabin. And there's two bathrooms. So yeah, it's bigger than my house for sure. It's pretty luxury down there. Yeah, so storage on the boat is there's three hatches down in the cockpit. One's like a ice bin, which has the ice chipper just feeds constantly ice into it when you turn it on. Then there's a kill bin underneath the center of the game chair, which is, you know, you can keep slurry in and keep your tunas in there or whatever, or you can store your buckets and that sort of stuff. Yeah, plenty of storage. Yeah, plenty of place for livies to swim around pretty happily in there. It's got a massive 240 volt pump that sort of rips into that. And so yeah, you can probably keep, I don't know, 30 or 40 slimies alive in there without even any issue. So the fastest I've ever had it was 42 knots, which is ripping. The fuel burn at that is, I don't know, you couldn't throw the $50 notes over the side quick enough. It'd be 400 litres a side per hour, so 800 litres an hour at that speed. But yeah, cruise speed would be 28, 26 knots, and that's burning about 160 litres an hour per engine, so 300 litres, 20 total. Yeah, it's a great sea boat, especially running into it. It's epic to run into like big swells and stuff in this boat. Yeah, it doesn't worry because it's got such big horsepower. Yeah, you can just sort of power through the waves without any sort of issues. Yeah, so in a flybridge, we've got the TZ Touch, which is our GPS. So that's interfaced into all the electronics are fully interfaced, so they all speak to each other. So the other screen is our sonar, forward-facing sonar. And then we got on the other side is our sounder, and if we got a radar as well that we can split screen onto any of those screens, and also you can watch Foxtel on one of the screens too if you get a little bit bored or on the run out. You can watch the footy. You can mark a fish and then sort of scroll back and put your finger on it. Waypoint. Yeah, you can go back around. The amount of fish that's caught me is just absolutely ridiculous because of that one feature. I can tell the difference between a striped marlin, blue marlin, black marlin, dolphin, tuna, with whatever they look like on the screen, which is pretty important. Leave it all to bloom.